Good morning, everyone. My name is Pauline Yunelli S. Tibay from BAT 3B, and today we're going to talk about successful company. If my topic was the main dish, all of our mentioned and to be mentioned topics are just an ingredient to my topic. Right before we start, I'd like to share a success story of a successful entrepreneur who lives here in Carmen. Her name is Engineer Imelda Laping. Who is Engineer Laping? She is a loving wife, a mother of three wonderful kids, a thoughtful friend, and a Laishu tita. Well, don't get me wrong, she wants to be called Laishu. She was a former employee of his brother, Engineer Carmelo Puno, at Camp Construction Supply. During that time, she was only earning minimum wage, and byuda siya aning time, guys. Wala pa siya na remarried. Wala siya katimbang sa ilang expenses sa balay, and because of that, she barely made her kids graduate. But thanks to her friends, who is very thoughtful to lend her money, she was able to send them all in a prestigious school. And as a matter of fact, one of them graduated at University of San Jose Recoletas as magna cum laude. And then, because of that, it made her ask herself, what if? What if I die poor and lonely? Well, nobody wants that, right? Well, ako na lang sad siguro, di ko ganun mamatay nga pobre o lonely. Bisag at least naman lang na-enjoy na ko akong life. And honestly, boring jud ang kinabuhi nga walay kwarta. And that's the sad truth. So at age 49, she left her job and started her own empire. She started a trading business, namely Mamel's Trading. So during those times, no one really believed in her. When she was seeking for investors, naglisagit siya. It is because of her age. Some of them asked na, why now nga? Tigwang naman ka. How will you able to handle it? But that did not stop Engineer Laping. As a matter of fact, she had one investor only pag first jud, and that is her husband. Yang second husband, that's the only person who believed in her, only invested in her business. So Mamel's Trading always believed na if ikaw tarong businesswoman, you will always make sure na everything is already permitted na mo prior operations bitaw, everything is smooth na nga, wala na makaali sa inyohang operations. So she made sure all business permits are being kuan bitaw, permitted already. So after that, she had clients from BFAR Region 7, PNP Region 7, Cebu Provincial Capital, cities of Lapu-Lapu, Talisay, Carcar, and Toledo, municipalities of Asturias, Dumanhog, Cordova, Consolacion, Carmen, and Sugod, and 11 barangays of Carmen, 4 barangays of Sugod, and DepEd Cebu City, Naga, and Talisay. And now she has a total of 34 investors. Ing ana kadako na ang business ni Mamel's. Only if you believe and trust in yourself, mulago gid imo ang business. So, now let's talk about my main topic. So, successful company. So, there are 4 subtopics around the oblong, which are ethical and legal behavior, creation of value, independence of owner's effort, and sustained stream of profit. Let's start with ethical and legal behavior. So, as mentioned earlier, Mamel's always made sure na everything is permitted prior operations. Of course, kay if mo function man good mo no as a business, or if mo operate na mo as a business without kanabitang permits, most unethical and illegal, kay diligid siya mulago in the long run. So naagid na siya possibility nga mudang gyapon imong business kay wala man mo nag-start properly. So, also the reason nga nung dapat ethical, mo practice taog ethical and legal behavior. So first, it fosters trust among your investors and it also builds strong reputation that allows to attract customers and investors. Because si Mamelts, kumpleto man siya sa documents, nakabuild siya og strong reputation niya. Moto hinungdan niya no ni daghan ang iyang investors og iyang customers. And because of that, naka-foster siya trust among his her customers and investors. So next is creation of value. So creation of value, di ba si Mamelts started from ground up, from ashes to ground up, wala gid siya nag salig sa kanang kumbitaw, kanang marketing sa uban na murag madawit na lang siya. No, she did not do that. She created her own value. She built her own brand reputation. So, mapod na ang usa kasagaran nga nung successful ang usa ka company. Kay, wala bitaw siya nagsalig sa uban. She made her own name. Ingana, she built her own empire. So, kibali pa. So next kay independence of honors efforts. Diba mentioned earlier nga nakagraduate na yung tulo ka anak. So all of these three are a part of her company. Her eldest son is the chairman of logistics. Her daughter, the second, the middle child, is the VP operations, and the last the youngest child is the VP marketing. So all of them function according sa ilang designation. So kaning tulo, since naman sila sa company silang mama, ilang mama kay kuan na gid na siya kanang tigperma na lang jud, based on my observation kay friends mo ni sa yung youngest child, tigperma na lang jud na ilang mama gid. So basically the business itself is already independent of the owner's efforts. So, unsa the pros and cons aning ma-independent ang usa ka company sa owner's efforts? First, pros, it only says na effective diyang task delegation among your organization. So, it only means na ang imuhang team is efficient. However, makadilute siya of vision kay magkapasa-pasa naman good ang information, which means, or which only kuan nga, ang vision, mura bitag mausab siya kadapasa ing ana kay makaingon ang mga workers na magay pakiatong kuan, owner. So, dili na lang po ta maninguha. So, that's one con of being independent of owner's efforts. So lastly, sustained stream of profit. As we all know, ang profit jud ang nakapabuhi sa usa ka company. Without this, mag-close jud, foreclosure jud ang kuan ang business. So unsa man yung pagkahibaw nga imuhang business naka-sustain sa profit? First, break-even point. So break-even point is when your profit and your og imuhang halin og ang imuhang giput up sa imong business is nag equal bitaw. Yeah, there is no gain and there is no loss. That is break even point. And actually, if makatungtong na mo sa break even point, that's only a starting point nga palago na jud ni akong business kay wala man jud nag start na business nga nilago dayon, like nakabawi dayon or nagtupong dayon ang loss og ang profit. Okay. Alkansa mo gitong tanan sa start sa itong business. So, break-even point is one sign niya, palago na niya akong business. So, next is net income ratio. After ni mo makahit sa mong break-even point, this is where you know nga, ni kwa na day ka, naka-profit na day ka. So, di rin ni mo mahibawaan niya, nakabawi na day ko. This is when you'll know nga, naka-kwarta na day ka sa imuhang business. So, once maka-net income ratio na mo, ma-sustain again ninyo ang profit, kana, that is, kuan, one way to become a successful financially sa usa ka company. Pero di ba, mao man ang aim sa tanan? That's all we are aiming for if we have our own company. To have a sustained stream profit to ensure nga wala ta na alkansi. So, basically, all of these are, kuan, achieved by Mamelts. Which only says na successful gyud ang company ni Mamelts. Let's proceed. So, P, Profits are lifeline or the lifeline to companies, help them grow strategically. So as mentioned earlier, profits jud ang nagpabuhi sa usa ka company. Next, ambitious entrepreneurs adopt and overcome challenges to achieve success. Pareha ni Mammals, nag-ambition na siya nga ma-successful, and now, successful na siya. Unwavering commitment drives every successful company forward. L, loyalty among colleagues forms the backbone of a strong foundation for a conducive work environment. I, independence from the owner's efforts allows for the company growth and sustainability beyond individual contributions. N, nurturing ethical practices ensures the company's sustained success. E, empowering employees fosters a culture of excellence essential for a successful company's sustained growth. Taas dito niya kung guys, be patient with me. Next, nurturing value the company thrives independently, ensuring a continuous flow of profit. E, efficient operations ensure a continuous stream of profit and independence for the successful company. O, optimize operations orchestrate the success of a company. N, nurturing talent nurtures the success of company. E, every effective endeavor enables success. L, leveraging strengths and successful company thrives. L, leadership is important as it sets the vision, inspires innovation, and cultivates a culture of excellence throughout the organization. And lastly, every successful company thrives beyond its owner's endeavors. So that would be all for my topic or my report. Thank you very much.